When developing any drag car, it's always easiest to go down the path that's already been well travelled and well proven. However, Nikki from Boosted86 Racing has gone down a completely different path with this Toyota 86 behind me, and this is in terms of the engine combination it's running. So Nikki, there's a lot of 86s out there all around the world, and of course Camrys and Celicas as well. The path is well and truly trodden with the Toyota 2JZ, so that would be the obvious choice. You've gone with something very different. Can you tell us what's in this car?
Yeah, so we've gone with the Landcruiser 1FZ motor. Originally it's a 4.5 litre, but we've destroked it to 3.9 litres to get the revs a bit higher and just be a stronger overall build for us.
Alright, so when you've got to develop this essentially from scratch, that's a lot of work. Generally that also comes with a reasonably high expense. So what was the impetus behind going the 1FZ over the 2JZ?
My partner's had the 2.7 litre, which is the four-cylinder Hilux motor.
And that's the 3RZ?
Yes, that's the one. And we found this to sort of be the big brother of it. And we saw 900 horsepower out of four cylinders. So, yeah, we didn't want to go the 2J, so we wanted to go this one and see what we could do.
I think it's fair to say as well that the 1FZ has been fairly well developed, particularly overseas. It was for a long time the engine of choice for sand drags and hill climbs, etc. So definitely no shortage of power available. Now, you just mentioned that you've destroked it down to 3.9 litres. Part of that was class rules?
Yeah, we can only be a 4 litre over here in Australia for Pro Turbo and Factory Extreme. So we wanted to build a car that we could race in all the classes, not just radial.
And can you talk to us about the process you've gone through? What do you use in terms of parts? Is this all developed in-house, or were you buying some off-the-shelf parts for the engine to get it where it needed to be?
Originally when we had the 4.5 litre, we were able to buy a few off-the-shelf parts, but once we destroked it, custom crank cams and all that sort of stuff, and we've just sort of had a few different combinations in there and just found the sweet spot now that we're really happy with.
In terms of the rotating assembly, if we start with the crankshaft, what is that? Have you got a modified stock crankshaft, or is it billet? Where have you gone?
We've got the billet crank in there, yeah, because they just don't make them strong enough.
In terms of the cylinder head, what have you done there to get the sort of airflow through it that you need to make the sort of power you're producing?
Yep, so all the water ports have been plugged and all that sort of stuff, and we've had a lot of porting and coating done by Performance Wholesale.
With the 1FZ, this is sort of a unique drive arrangement for the camshaft as well, because it runs sort of a scissor arrangement where it drives one cam and then the other cam is driven off the first cam. Does that cause you any issues in terms of your cam selection and cam timing adjustment?
Not that I'm aware of. Justin from JW Automotive looks after all the tuning and engine development for us. But he sort of, develops what he thinks is best for the motor and the combination and what we're trying to achieve.
Now, clearly it's working. We actually haven't talked about your record so far, but this car's gone 655 at 217, which is a world record for six-cylinder radial, is it?
Yeah, that's correct. So we're the fastest import radial car in the world. So that basically just means it's the fastest six-cylinder, and yeah, we're not too far behind the V8s.
In terms of the power that it's producing to run those sort of times, and I think you've also said it's run as fast as 219 mile an hour on another pass, can you give us an estimate of what sort of power the engine is producing?
It's about 2,500 horsepower.
With that radial tyre, are you sort of power limited to how much you can put to the track, or could you actually produce more power and go faster still?
We're actually out of turbo at the moment, so that's pretty much what's limiting us going faster.
What is that turbo right now?
We've got a 98mm Garrett on there.
Okay, so we're seeing a lot of the competitors, particularly the 2JZs, running 106, even 110mm turbos. Is it as simple as stepping up to 106mm turbo and going a tenth of a second faster?
Yeah, that's what we're waiting on at the moment. We've got a G57 on the way. It just didn't make it here in time for this weekend. So we're hoping to put that on and, take it out the back door.
Just talking about the rest of the package with this car, can you talk to us about the electronic system in it, the computer that you've got controlling the engine? Because that's quite unique as well, the way you've got that set up.
Yeah, so we run the Link ECU. We actually run two Xtremes, just because we've got a lot of data getting monitored on the car and sensors and all that sort of stuff. So it's just easier to split over the two Xtremes and just monitor it that way.
All right, so in terms of those two ECUs, this is quite unusual. So you've gone this path because you've got a limited number of inputs for the data logging. Is that what I can understand from that?
Yes, that's correct. Yeah.
So one ECU essentially is running the engine, the other for data logging purposes?
Yeah, just other sensors around the motor and like shock sensors and all that sort of stuff, yeah.
Now, in terms of the engine management itself, you've got number of injectors on this. So you're running stage injection, and can you talk us through the injectors that are fitted?
Yeah, so we've got the 2400 cc Siemens injectors, and we've got three sets of those. So we've got a primary set, and then we've got duals in the secondary stage, and then we've also got a couple of upstream injectors as well.
One of the challenges with a radial tyre car is making sure the car stays hooked up from the moment you leave the line, and that power management is so key. So can you talk to us about how you are managing the power? And I'm guessing this really comes down to the boost control as the car goes down the track.
Yeah, so Justin and the team at JW Automotive, they look after everything on the car. We've got Santhuff shocks in the front and AFCOs in the rear. It's pretty simple, no two ways or four ways or anything like that. And yeah, we've just had a lot of R&D to make sure the car goes down nicely, and yeah, that's pretty much.
Well, clearly with a 655 at 217 mile an hour, whatever you're doing at the moment is working, and certainly look forward to seeing what the car can do with a little bit more turbo, as long as you can maintain a bit of traction. So congrats, and look forward to seeing how the car goes the rest of this weekend.
Thanks very much.
If you like that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up, and if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week. And if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson.